put some olive oil in here, just like that. And then in goes the chicken. You know, because it's an electric stove, the heat in the wok, it dissipates quickly. Just for a gas stove, the heat will remain more constant.
So when you put the cold chicken into a hot wok, the thing will start to drop the temperature.
Yes. But you know, it still stays hot enough to cook the chicken. So I use the... you'd be surprised, in about 4 or 5 minutes, this chicken will be almost done. In the meantime, I'll take the mustard cabbage off. At this point, I'm gonna add just a teaspoon of this is chili garlic sauce. It's not hot, but it's really, really good. That's really what it's much of this. And if you wanted, you know, you could add some chili pepper. And I usually like to cook this until the liquid is kind of cooks down. It's actually a little thick. So you don't want it to be too soupy, yeah? So the chicken, basically, it's done. I'm just letting it cook so I can get some of the liquid to cook down. Once I get the mustard cabbage in, there's going to be a lot of liquid. And I'll show you how to do it again in a second. couple more minutes, it's going to be hot. Now, once you get it to this stage here, you could add mustard, cabbage, or beans. Sometimes I chop up some mushrooms and mushrooms. I add some frozen bean onions. You can buy the green onions at Sam's and big bunches like that and you chop them all up. And actually at this point, the chicken is done. You could actually eat this with some brown rice if you really, really want it. I'm going to put some mustard cabbage in, so I'm going to take the chicken out first.
So the cooked chicken you remove before putting...
Yeah. Because you know the mustard cabbage has so much liquid in it. If you throw it in together right away, the liquid will actually lighten the color of this stuff. This is liquid. Yeah. Just take some
this in here. And that thing will cook way down.
Yeah, it will cook way down. And this mustard cabbage, you don't have to cook it for long either, you know. If you cook it too long, it starts to get a little soupy, and you don't want that.
You use a lot of mustard cabbage, then.
Yeah, but you know, it cooks down, it looks like there's a lot, but it cooks down so much, and usually I would use all of this, so that I'm eating more mustard cabbage than chicken. But for today,
And then you add the chicken back in.
Yeah, just let it cook just a little while, so it's a crunchy part, at least partly cooked. That's good.
So you recombine it again.
Yeah.
So this is actually a simple dish then.
Yep, this is all it is right here.
Wow.
And, just take this off of the burner. So it'll stop cooking.